right now, and we have to catch a 5:30 p.m. key flight. So we'll do some time pass at the airport now. We'll probably eat something, and I've also downloaded some movies on Netflix because it's a 6-hour long flight. So that is for my flight time pass. So yes, see you in Seattle. Finally landed in Seattle. The flight was pretty long, it was 6 hours, but the food was good, so we were just talking and eating on repeat mode. And we even got stuck on the runway for about 30 minutes, so the flight got delayed. And now Ashish's cousin Shreya is coming to pick us up. Really tired, and we'll just go to a place and sleep for now. But I am super excited for tomorrow morning, because tomorrow we are leaving for Victoria in British Columbia, and it's considered to be one of the most beautiful cities of Canada. Good morning, it's 7 in the morning and we are at the Clipper Ferry Terminal. So we are going to be taking a ferry to Victoria, and it is quite cold right now. It's going to take us about 3 hours to reach Victoria. So yes, and last night was good. We slept really well, but थोड़ी थोड़ी नींद तो आ रही है अभी भी.
It was amazing to kick off this trip with some time on water, because this Clipper ferry ride that connects United States with Canada travels through some scenic spots and offers stunning views. And in less than 3 hours, we saw the beautiful Victorian buildings and knew we had reached our destination. The capital city of the Canadian province of British Columbia, Victoria is known to be a perfect weekend getaway. And we could feel its beauty and charm as soon as we stepped out of the ferry.
Sometime back, checked in our hotel, refreshed our makeup, and now we are going to pick up our rental car because we have to leave for Bouchard Gardens. Actually, our hotel is in the downtown area and Bouchard Gardens is half an hour drive from here. And we have also booked high tea in Bouchard Gardens because apparently in Victoria they serve special English style high teas. And yeah, it's a very pretty place, flowers all around, greenery, and we can see small Victorian houses everywhere.
It was a beautiful sunny day, and the songs playing in the car were even better. And in just less than half an hour, we reached the famous Bouchard Gardens. CNN, National Geographic and USA Today have all named Bouchard Gardens one of the world's top gardens. And we couldn't agree more. There's a variety of landscapes within this garden, including the sunken garden, rose garden, Japanese garden, Italian garden, and so on. And each one of them was absolutely stunning. And then there was this breathtaking fountain. And finally, Ashish and Shreya agreed to come on camera for a minute. After soaking in the beauty of these delightful floral displays, it was now time for one of the most exciting part of this trip, the famous Victorian high tea. Victoria, named after Queen Victoria, has retained a little bit of old England. And one of those lovely traditions still going strong after more than a century is high tea. So we decided to take this traditional afternoon tea experience in the Bouchard Gardens dining room restaurant. The menu was placed before us and we were asked to choose a tea from the list. Soon the gleaming silver teapots were placed in the table, followed by this beautiful three-tier platter. It included warm traditional delicacies, savory tea sandwiches, and house-made sweets. With all three of us being foodies, this was probably the best experience we had in this trip. After chilling for a bit and shopping some souvenirs from the garden gift shop, we headed back to explore some other places of the town.
And Shreya is driving the car very happily.
But she's
going to try it out. She's still high on the high
tea. It was a beautiful drive. And our next stop was Victoria's Chinatown. This is the oldest Chinatown in Canada and has this ornately decorated gate of harmonious interest marking the entrance to Chinatown Center on Fisgard Street. It is also home to tons of authentic shops, restaurants and cafes. Although for us the main attraction here was Fantan Alley, known to be the narrowest street in Canada. Comprising of some locally owned, colorful shops and bakeries, this pretty little street is just 35 inches wide at its smallest point. And I was literally amazed by this fact. After clicking tons of pictures here, we took a stroll along the beautiful streets of downtown, Johnson Street being a really pretty one. Locally known as Lojo or Lower Johnson, this street is the perfect place to go for trendy boutique shopping in a picture-perfect setting. It's lined with Victorian-era buildings, painted in different colors, coupled with a large number of fashion and accessory shops. It was now dinner time and looking for vegetarian options, we came across Noodle Box. One thing we noticed in Victoria was there was much more number of people on the streets at night than we could see during the day, as if the whole city had come to life. And the most prominent attraction was these Parliament buildings lined with thousands of lights. Overlooking Victoria's Inner Harbour, these buildings are a 19th century icon. And seeing them serving as a backdrop to these horse-drawn carriages was even prettier. Taking a walk at the calm Inner Harbour at night was so relaxing. My eyes were repeatedly drawn to these reflections in water. Victoria is also known to have a great nightlife scene with many pubs, bars and restaurants. We just chilled around for a while before heading back to our hotel.
Good morning, it's our day 2 in Victoria. We got up really late today, so kind of feeling lazy. It's 11:30 in the morning right now and we have come to see a very pretty castle. And today there's a prediction of drizzle or rain, so we plan to do all the indoor activities including this castle, and then we'll probably go to Fairmont Empress Hotel and see the miniature world, which is kind of famous over here. And we have to take our ferry back to Seattle at 5 in the evening, so we have to get free by 4. We hardly have 3 to 4 hours left, so let's see what all we can cover and how the day goes.
Built between 1887 and 1890, this famous sandstone castle is now a National Historic Site and provides self-guided tours for the visitors. It has 39 lavishly furnished rooms with beautiful stained glass windows and ornately carved woodwork. We also got a little insight on the story of its first owner, Robert Dunsmuir, and the family drama that followed after his death. This Victorian era mansion is surely worth a visit if you like beautiful architecture and lavish decor. For the lunch, we found this perfect vegan restaurant with a very creative menu.
Amazing, and now it's drizzling and we are going to miniature world, that's indoors, so we don't have to worry about that. Just parked the car and walking towards it, so we'll just get the tickets and we just have 1 hour left for the miniature world, so we'll try and wrap up quickly. We have to return the car and then we have to get back to our ferry.
Housed in the famous Fairmont Empress Hotel, Miniature World is one of the most popular tourist attractions of Victoria. This little museum brings everything from historical battles to childhood fantasy lands to life in miniature and has over 85 great little attractions, including one of the longest model railways. It was amazing to get a bite-sized glimpse of Canada's history in this one-of-a-kind Victorian experience. And this, I would say, is a perfect activity for the young and young at heart. Also took a quick walk in the beautiful lawns of the Fairmont Empress Hotel. And finally made sure to buy some traditional Canadian maple cookies, teas and chocolates before catching our ferry back to Seattle. We made some great memories in this pretty little town and spent the following 4 days in Seattle, which will be covered in my next vlog. Do share and give a thumbs up if you like this one. Subscribe to my channel and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!